Hi, this is Ms. Sherbin again, and this is lesson six on cells. And we need to go over a little bit more than what was covered in the reading. So this is a very important video, and I will briefly cover the top 10 things you need to know about cells. I do recommend that you do get a notepaper and a pen just to jot some of these things down. They are very important. You need to know these top 10 things about cells before you go on to high school. And we'll go over each one briefly, and then we'll go and answer the questions. Right, so the first thing that you need to know about cells, is that all living things are made up of cells. You, me, plants, bacteria. Everything that is living is made up of cells. That's called cell theory. Cells are microscopic. That means that they can't be seen without a microscope. And we didn't know that cells existed until we had a microscope. And Robert Hooke was the first one to discover cells in a cork. He saw little boxes that remind him of cells, like in a monastery or like a prison. And even though this is not a microscope, it's just showing you in a cartoon view that all cells are itsy bitsy, and you yourself are made up of cells, and trillions of them make up you. And we have special cells, specialized cells like blood cells, skin cells, eye cells, all these different types of cells that make us who we are. All living things are organized. So it starts off with cells right here. Okay, this is where life first begins. Then you have tissues, organs, organ systems, and organisms. Again, we did talk about this in a previous video this year. The link is at the bottom of your screen. I do highly suggest that you do rewatch it. So there, before you have cells, you have organelles. And there are differences between plants and animal cells, as we can see in this picture over here up top. Plant cells not only are shaped like a box, but they have organelles that a plant cell does not. And you need to know what the structure and the function of the following organelles are. And these aren't all the organelles, these are just the most important ones that you need to be familiar with before you go to high school and for the test. So the first one is the nucleus. It's in the center of the cell. It is what we call the boss because it contains all the information you need to create life, to create new cells. And this is the hereditary information or DNA. It is present in both animal and plant cells. The mitochondria or the powerhouse is the site of cellular respiration. I should say site of cellular respiration, and it's the process, cellular respiration is a process which organisms take food and turn it into usable energy, ATP. This is what the mitochondria looks like. This is also the mitochondria down here. But again, both present animal and plant cells. The cell membrane, the outside of the cell, it's in both plant and animal cells. It's like the gatekeeper or the bouncer if the cell was a club. It allows certain materials in and other materials out. Again, present in both animal and plant cells. The cell wall is a rigid structure that's only present in plant cells, and it gives it the strength and the shape. So you can see here, here's the cell wall, this green box right here, and the cell membrane. So the plant cell does have both a cell membrane and cell wall. An animal cell does not have a cell wall. That's why we're able to move more freely than a plant. But that's what allows a plant to stand upright. That's what the bark or the wood of a tree is made of, the cell wall. Chloroplast, again, only present in plant cells. It's like the solar panels. It's the site of photosynthesis. Again, that's really important to know. Photosynthesis is where the plant makes food, and it's only present in plant cells. It's also what makes the plant green because it contains the green pigment chlorophyll. The vacuole is like the storage room. It holds waste and other and useful materials until the plant needs it, either to get rid of it or to store it. There is a big central vacuole in a plant cell. Even both plants and animals have a vacuole. Only the plants have a large vacuole. And it's what allows the plant, other than the cell wall, to help it stand upright. When you don't water a plant, it gets wilted because the vacuole deflates and it doesn't have enough water to keep the pressure of the cell. So, as you can see right here, here is a vacuole that's full of water, and here's a vacuole that's not full of water, and that's what happens to a plant when the central vacuole decreases. And even though we went over this in the previous slide, this is just super important to know, so I made it its own individual point. The nucleus is where it contains the DNA or genetic material or hereditary information. Those are all three words for the same thing. Genetic material, hereditary information, or DNA. Chloroplasts are what make the plant cell green, and it is the site of photosynthesis where the plant makes its own food. And the mitochondria is the site of cellular respiration. It's when cells turn glucose into usable energy and waste as carbon dioxide. Okay, the next thing that we need to talk about is cell division. So here is a parent cell, right? It creates two identical daughter cells when we undergo cell division. And each generation produces double. So the first generation, we have one cell, it divides, we get two cells. Next generation, we get four cells, and then we get eight cells. Here's a video of what cell division looks like. So the cells divide into two, then those two divide into four, eight, and they keep on multiplying by two. Okay, so they're identical, and they multiply by two each generation. In unicellular organisms, they use cell division to reproduce, and this is a type of asexual reproduction. And in multicellular organisms, cell division is used for growth and repair. So our cells don't get bigger. As we get bigger, we get more cells. And when, for example, we break a bone, it heals by making new cells to replace the ones that were damaged. And when there's abnormal cell division, when something goes wrong, that is essentially cancer. Okay, and now we're ready to go over questions and answers in our book. So take a second, get to your book. And here we are. Question number one. What are the four functions of cells that are the same in all organisms? So cells grow. They reproduce, they take in nutrients, and they use nutrients for energy and to make new cell material. Two, compare the function of a cell membrane with a cell wall. Here, let me make that so you guys can see it. Okay. The cell membrane surrounds the cytoplasm and decides what may enter and exit the cell. The cell wall is outside the cell membrane and gives the cell shape and protection. Number three, why do plants need chloroplasts? Plants need chloroplasts because they contain chlorophyll, the green pigment that makes photosynthesis possible. And photosynthesis is the process which makes the cell food. So it's how a plant gets the glucose. Okay, so number four asks why bacteria are neither plants nor animals, and I include a bacteria cell. And there's many varieties of bacteria, so we're talking about in general. So, in the reading, it also told us that some bacteria need to take in nutrients because they cannot make their own food like animals. Other bacteria can make their own food like plants, so bacteria are neither plants nor animals. Number five, a scientist discovers a cell that she thinks is a new species of organism. She notices that the genetic material, it has genetic material, but it is not enclosed in a nucleus, kind of like right here. Could this still be considered a cell? Explain. Yes, it is bacteria because bacteria do not have a nucleus and it is a cell. So, since it is a cell, it is living. Okay, so directions 6 through 9. For each question, write your answers in the space provided. Base your answers to the questions 6 through 9 on the paragraph and the diagram below. So, Euglena are microscopic single-celled organisms that live in freshwater ponds. They grow and reproduce. Euglena are green and can use the energy in sunlight to make their own food. So that tells me it can photosynthesize. And if you look over here, there's a chloroplast. However, Euglena are not plants. Oh, interesting. They sometimes obtain their nutrients by taking in other microorganisms. Ooh. So they also do something like kind of like what consumers do. Euglena can move from place to place by whipping a tail like flagella back and forth. The diagram shows the structure of a typical Euglena. So this is a flagellum that they're talking about. It has a vacuole, starch granule, cytoplasm, nucleus. So if you look over here too, I'm going to show you, get rid of the markings for a second. This is what, whoops. This is what a Euglena looks like. All right, you can see here it has a chloroplast, it has that flagellum they're talking about. Can't really see the nucleus in this one, but here is a labeled picture. All right, so these are all real Euglenas. They do exist. All right, so number six asks, explain why Euglena is a living thing. So Euglena is a cell that carries out life processes, so is a living thing. So it can grow and reproduce, it can create food, it takes in food, it responds to stimuli. Number seven, in what ways is Euglena like all other cells? Well, from diagram we saw that the Euglena is like other cells because it has a nucleus, cytoplasm, and a cell membrane. It reproduces and takes in nutrients. How is Euglena like a plant cell? How is it like an animal cell? Well, it's like a plant cell because it has a chloroplast and therefore can make its own food. And it's like an animal cell because it does not have a cell wall and it takes in nutrients and it can move from place to place. Number nine. Early scientists were confused by Euglena because they wanted to classify all organisms as either plants or animals. So they wanted to create a new group of organisms and put Euglena in this group. Why do you think these scientists were confused? Explain whether their solution was a good one or not. The scientists were confused because the Euglena are like animal cells in some ways, but like plant cells in other ways. So that means that they couldn't classify it as either one. I think it was a good solution to put Euglena as a new group because they could not be classified as plant or animal cells. And this is very true. If you look over here, we have where we can see animals and plant cells. We can also find things like protists and bacteria. The Euglena falls in the Protista group somewhere along here. So it was one of the first specimens of the Protista that helped define this new kingdom. All right, number 10. What is the building block of all living things? The cell, chloroplast, nucleus, and cytoplasm. Well, the chloroplast, the nucleus, and the cytoplasm can't be the building block of all living things. First, the chloroplast is only found in things like the Euglena and plant cells. And without these, on their own, they can't survive on their own. They need the cell. So, cell is the first block of living things, it's the smallest unit of living things. Which following statements is true? Cells don't need nutrients? That sounds wrong to me. Cells definitely need nutrients. Chloroplast contains a cell's genetic material? Would that should be a red flag. The nucleus contains genetic material. Cells grow and reproduce? Yes, they do. All non-living things are made up of cells. No way. All living things are made up of cells. So, cells grow and reproduce. And today's secret word is nucleus. Number 12. Which of the following is found in a plant cell but not an animal cell? Plant cell but not an animal cell. Okay, cell membrane, they both have that cell wall. Ooh, animal cells do not have a cell wall. Cytoplasm, we both have that. Nucleus, both have that. Cell wall, it is. Number 12. Which of the following is true about all cells? True. The genetic material is found in the cytoplasm. Nope, that's only in the things we saw, like the bacteria. They're usually found in the nucleus, which separates it from the cytoplasm. They grow and reproduce. Yes. They obtain and use nutrients. Obtain. So plant cells don't really obtain. They create nutrients using photosynthesis. They are found in multicellular organisms. So some cells are found in unicellular organisms, which means they only need one cell. So, yep. All multicellular organisms have cells, but not all cells are found in multicellular organisms. So all cells do grow and reproduce. Number 14, which part of euglena is also found in an animal cell? A cell wall, not in an animal cell. Chloroplast, not in an animal cell. Nucleus, yes. Chlorophyll, nope. If there's no chloroplast, there's going to be no chlorophyll. So both have a nucleus, correct. Which organism could this cell be from? So it's not a square like a plant cell. It does not have any, looks like chloroplast, so it could be a human because we have animal cells. Maple leaf? Nope, not a plant cell. An alga, like algae? No, doesn't have chloroplast. Euglena? Definitely not like that little euglena we saw earlier. So, number one, a human. All right, thank you, and don't forget to review the other video that we talked about cells and the organization of living things. It's very important that you know this information. Have a good day.